can talk. And then it's really hard.
What we have in front of us is a really moving, motivational, intimate evening that is devoted to mental well-being. The reason why winter solstice was chosen is because it is the longest night of the year. It is there as the perfect metaphor, that idea that the moon stands still, the sun disappears, and the night seems to extend forever. However, every night has its dawn, and despite the length and the gloom of winter solstice, there is light at the other end.
A miner in a mine couldn't find what I thought of you.
Tonight is a wonderful night. Tonight we are here to celebrate life. To celebrate the life of our loved ones that are not here anymore.
Dalang niani dumari dumara, niani mujigam, maro dabu yala. Which is today we pay respects to the elders, past and present.
We're joined at the heartbeat here tonight. And as Auntie Nancy said, look around and give thanks for the community that listens.
Make new friends and keep new friends and keep the other and the others over and the others over.
What is really amazing to me now is even when our services are not available, we can ensure that people can connect, that they can get the support that they need. This might be an event for 1,000 people, but through Twitter and Facebook and all of our social media contacts, it reaches hundreds of thousands of people. And when you think about the power of voice and the way in which voices can change, we are going to see a massive change in how we support people.
Twilight's herons who were almost too lightfoot to land. Pearl galahs in pink-fronted confederacy, each starring in its frame. Or it may be a misty candelabrum of egrets, lambent before Saint Sleep, who gutter awake and balance stiffly off.
And as survivors of suicide, there's one thing we share in common. And that's the heartache, that's the questions, that's the not knowing why, what went wrong, where it all went, and how we got to this place. Let's listen to listen. Treat every single person with compassion, because everyone is fighting a battle we know nothing about.
Let it be, let it be, oh let it be, let it be, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be.
Everyone here has a story of heartbreak, or a story of hope, or a story of just living day by day. And I woke up to an email from Dad, and it read, "Sweetheart, I can't live like this anymore. I'm writing you this email to tell you that I'm going out to the car because I'm going to end it. I love you so much, Dad." And Dr. Ralph, bless him, put my dad on some antidepressants, but the third type suited his system. But if medication works, then that's tremendous too. And that medication, I believe, has kept my father alive for all of these years.
Warrior, warrior, just reach out for the light. Warrior, warrior.
The suicide never goes alone. They take everyone with them. That's the thing. Someone in that darkest space feels so alone. And yet, if only they knew how loved and connected they are. And it's almost their absence, tragically, that proves that. I just love for everyone here tonight to take away that idea that there might be someone right beside you, it might be that person that needs a conversation, that needs that connection. Don't be shy. As Joe said, listen, don't just hear. It makes the world of difference.
We all need somebody to lean on. We all need somebody to lean on.